Good morning, Comets, and welcome to the last day of this very slow week.
You're so right. This week has been so slow.
But a very special way to end this week is the marching band's final performance tomorrow at King's High School.
Good luck to everyone in band, and congratulations on a fantastic season.
And if you see someone in marching band, give them a high five.
I wonder how the weather will be today and tomorrow.
What can you tell us, Alicia?
Good morning, Comets. I'm here to happily inform you guys you are on day zero of note fog. But now we are on day one of high winds. Today we'll have a high of 73 and a low of 57 with a lovely mix of clouds and sun with winds traveling to 10 to 20 miles per hour. And speaking of high winds, when our band travels over to King's Hill, right next to King's Island, on Saturday they'll have some highly unfortunate weather on our last comp of the season with it being mostly cloudy and windy. While showers developing later that day with a high of 73 and a low of 50, winds will be traveling to 20 to 30 miles per hour. But despite all that gross weather, I know our band will still go and perform our very best. I hope you all drive safe with this wind. Back to you, anchors.
Thanks, Alicia.
Now we've got some congratulations to send out to our students of the month. They are
freshman Gage Turner,
sophomore Chris Bustamante,
junior Amal Suleiman,
and senior Beau Goins.
Good job to all of you, and way to be a Comet.
Now here's some things going on.
Well, first up, a cancellation. Chess Club is canceled.
But on Monday, we have Creative Writing Club in the morning at 7:30 in the ERC. And then after school, the Astronomy Club meets to discuss a trip to Perkins Observatory. They meet in room 260.
Now, here's some other things that are coming up.
Do you like being scared?
No.
Do you enjoy haunted houses? Well, lucky for you, the Sensor Crossing Theater Department will host a haunted house tonight. Our haunted theater will be open from 4 to 7. And admission to the theater is only $1, and all proceeds go to support the theater department.
Now, this Sunday is daylight savings, so remember to set your clocks 1 hour back.
And then staff and those of you 18 years or older, remember to vote on Tuesday, November 8th.
Finally, remember that a great way to give back is by donating blood. Take a look.
Giving blood. I was excited to do it.
I like to help people.
It's just a small way that I can try to give back.
It feels like you're doing a good thing for society.
It means a lot to me that my donation is going to go out to help somebody.
It's a very worthwhile opportunity to give back to the community.
It's easy. You can help strangers. That's the best feeling in the world, helping strangers.
I tend to think, you know, what if it was a family member or someone I knew who needed blood, I would want it to be there for them.
Everybody needs to have the chance for life, and this is one of those opportunities to do that for people.
As a physician, firsthand, I get to see the importance of blood and people that are in need of blood transfusions. Such a simple thing that without a lot of effort that you can do to actually save someone's life.
Come on out and help.
Donate blood with the Red Cross.
Remember that one donation can save three lives. If you are over 16 and have parental consent, you can donate blood during your lunch, study hall, or lockout periods on November 9th. See Dr. Fuller for more information.
Just a few more things for you juniors and seniors. Next week is the last week that colleges will be visiting Central Crossing. We have Sinclair Community College, Wilberforce University, the University of Toledo, and Otterbein. So be sure to sign up in your cohort Google Classroom.
And then looking way ahead, if you are interested in the College Credit Plus program, please plan to attend the CCP Information Night on Wednesday, January 25th at 6:30 p.m. here at Central in the auditorium. Your family must plan to attend if you want to participate in the College Credit Plus program during the 23-24 school year.
This meeting will outline College Credit Plus program, the risks and benefits of participating, the various options for taking college courses while still attending high school.
CCP is such a great opportunity. It allows you to have a college experience as a high school student. You can take classes on campus, online, or here at Central. Personally, I take on-campus classes, and it's a lot of fun, and it's been a very good experience. I mean, who doesn't love getting college credit for free?
There's so many things going on here at Central, so let's over to our sports.
Take it away, sporters.
Good morning, Comet. I'm Jordan.
And I'm Michelle.
Oh my god, what's wrong?
It's our last day in sports.
Well, here's Bosco to cheer you up, but don't worry, because this spectacular, amazing duel will return maybe even next week.
Yeah, you're right. Let's get going with sports, though.
First, once again, we have football. Congrats to send out to our all-district football players.
First team, all-district Malik Kamara.
Special mention, all-district Colin Hendricks.
Honorable mention, all-district Josh Kojo.
And honorable mention, all-district Kenny Kemper. Good job to each of you. We are Comet proud of our football program and each one of you. Now let's talk about preseason information.
Just a reminder that all preseason information is on the Cafe TVs. In addition to what you'll see there, we do have a few highlights.
Baseball will be back outside next week. The schedule is Tuesday, November 8th from 3:45 to 5:45, followed by lifting. And then Thursday, November 10th from 3:45 to 5:45, followed by lifting, which will be done at 8:30 at absolute latest.
Any questions, see Coach Poge in room 172 or email him in the email below.
And then indoor track will begin practice on Monday, November 7th. From 3:45 to 5:45, and it will take place from Monday through Thursday.
If you are interested, make sure that you have a current physical on file and fill out the necessary paperwork.
Be sure to bring water and be prepared to work outside. If you have any questions, please see Coach Reggie Cannon or Coach Clint Reardon.
Softball lifting will start next week, November 8th, and be every Tuesday and Thursday from 6:30 a.m. to 7:30 a.m.
If you have any questions or are just interested in softball, please see Coach B in room 162.
While we don't have any games tonight, our winter sports is getting started this Saturday.
Boys varsity, JV, and freshman basketball play with Marion Harding High School at home at 10 a.m.
So come out and support your Comet.
Well, that's all that's all for today.
Back to you, anchors.
Well, we have so many sports starting up in the next few days.
And basketball is the first of our winter sports to get started this Saturday.
Thanks, Michelle and Jordan, for all that preseason information.
And seniors, if you have pictures on the school store, make sure you go and grab them.
Now, please rise for the pledge. The pledge stands for so many things in this country and shows another way to support those who fought for us. Here's Logan to lead us.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thanks, Logan, and thanks to all of you who participated.
Well, that's all we have for you today on a very special day.
What kind of day is that?
National Chicken Lady Day.
What in the world is that?
It celebrates Dr. Dupree, who led numerous efforts to improve education in her community through chicken.
Is that a Canes thing?
Nope. Something completely different.
Anyways, goodbye, Central.
Bye.